Hey, this is James, back with another project on the 2001 Tiffin Allegro Bus 35 IP Freightliner chassis XC ISP 300. These are all the specs. What I've got going on now, if you watch some of my other videos I've already done, I've been under the bus a lot lately. I've done airbags front and back. I did the air dryer full service, service rebuild with those kits. It's early November 2023. And now I'm gonna hit the relay valve and back. The back relay valve basically gets a small signal from the front on the small airlines and then opens the valve for the tanks that are on the back of the air tanks on the back of the bus. Underneath, everything is basically, see if I can get my finger to work right behind my shoulder there where I got my test paint on the front part of the axles where I'll be working at today. And you know, I did the ABS on the ABS sensor on the front of the bus plus greasing earlier today, and that's in a different video. And I'm also going to grease up what I can here in the back. Here's the rebuild kit. That's the number four. It's a 12R is the type of valve, I guess. There's also a 1214, but apparently they're interchangeable, I guess. Yeah, I worked with Find a Part. I was able to get the part number off. You'll see I did some diagnostic videos earlier that will be out of sync that I'll cut in here in a second, and where I was able to get the part number off, and then I used Find a Part to get the repair kit. Probably the easier thing to do is to actually buy a whole brand new valve. It's only not that much more expensive, and probably if you're a do-it-yourselfer, that's the easiest way to do it. But this is more fun, I think. I hope. You know, it's always when you're working on the brakes, it is the brakes. So, and it is 22,000 pounds of moving metal that can hurt somebody. Well, kill them probably. And so be careful. I am not an expert. I don't know, this first time I've ever done this. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm only showing you, giving you a clue of how I did it. And if you don't think you can do it, you definitely have a professional do it. Cause you know, it is brakes, right? Here we go. All right, we're up under here. This is it. This is the guy, the exhaust valve that I'm trying to get fixed. So these two sides, these two airlines go right down to the brake diaphragm here. And I made sure the system's empty. And so they're gonna be, you know, I'm gonna take off here, off there, off right here. Two signal lines right there. Those are gonna be the hardest to get off. There's one more on this big black, this medium-sized black line right here. And then a bolt here. I think they're 15, 13 or 15. And a bolt on the other side. I'm gonna drop that down and bring it to the workbench. What I've had to do in the past is on these press-on fittings, it's not press-on, but it's, there's a, I think these will come off easy. These ones will have a little piece of metal in there. The little, oops, see, I got the big, my fingers in the way. On these two, these here, I'll have to lightly, have to wiggle back and forth very carefully because I don't want to break this line. I don't trust the plastic. I hope it's not that brittle. They, from working with them now, they don't seem to be that brittle, but still gonna be careful because I don't want to get experience on how to change all this stuff, how to change these lines. But that one wouldn't be too bad if I had to do it because it terminates up in that other area. That's the Wabco on frame. I think it's a Mark D ABS. And then up above here is, yeah, this is the relay valve, and then this is another relay type valve, and then you have each actuator for your ABS. Hopefully y'all can see that where I'm pointing. One more just right there. So you got one on each side too, so that modulates based off what the computer thinks. If you lost traction, and then up above is your air tank. I forget if there's one or two. I think there's two. Nope, just one. There's two up front, one on the back. Got it out on the bench here. Here we go. It was actually really simple. 22, they pop right off. They're the easiest. 21 on that guy. Whew, I think this is a 15. And these are the ones, these where the plastic tubing slides over these. Or the hard, you just have to, I use a soft mallet with a soft hit. Don't want to break it. I keep on reiterating that. You really have to wiggle. I was very ginger on these lines for a while. It would take me a long time, but I've gotten more brave and I give it a good wiggle and off they pop. And this guy, this is, this should have a tube coming out of it like that, but and it does, it's just in the, it's still in the plastic tubing. And when I was working on my rear air brakes, you know, they came out as well. So sometimes they stay in, sometimes they came out. Either way, not that big a deal. And then these did turn out to be just 13s, 13 millimeters. And I used a ratcheting wrench. You can do it with a spanner socket as well, but yeah, something like this is the best, easiest. Gosh, maybe 20 minutes to get that guy off. So let's dig into it here. There's no instructions on the kit, so we're just gonna go for it. And I may end up stopping to figure out where the silicone grease goes. Probably goes on this guy right here. Yeah, this is where this is going to be replaced. New snap ring, spring, something else, O-rings. Probably up there. Hopefully we don't have to take any of these off. If I do, we just got to remember which way they're clocked. You know, 12 o'clock. You know, however we want to put that. You know, these are all at 12 o'clock and 6 o'clock if I reference this as up and down. So clocking just means remember where these put. If you have to take these out so that when you go back to put it back together, you don't have to do any of this under the bus. All right, just a snap ring tool. You'll have to have one of these. You either get it from the cheap Chinese tool store, which I probably wouldn't. I think I got these out of the auto store, so they might be cheap, but you know, hopefully I won't lose it across the garage. Wow. That's a first. All right. So bam, bam, there we go. So old parts, new parts. And over off camera, I'm just laying the parts in order. Let's see if I can turn this without. You see right there, I'm just going to start laying them in order so I remember how they go back together. So it looks like this piece is next. All right, I pulled out of there very easily. Compare them. You can see that's a seating surface there. Oh, and this piece goes on there. Further in, now we just got O-rings and grease to figure out. 14 or 15? Oh, it's a 14. Tidy, lefty, loosey. And also what I've noticed too is none of the stuff on the air systems is really torqued down. It's all hand tight. Alright, so I'm pretty sure that's where these next two are going to go. And oh, this buddy of mine, soft persuasion, love it. So that's what I used on the airlines. Just a little tap. See the diaphragm in here that I think when the signal line from the foot pedal right here either creates a vacuum or pressure you know, it causes the air to come in through here on the feed line, and then out down to the bags, down to the brakes to apply them. So let's see, we got two O-rings. So it looks like it's for that one there. Just kind of going for it here. I wonder if I push that. Oh yeah, there you go. So I just push that out, and here we go. And I see an O-ring, and I see the grease. And the only other, oh, so we got, we're missing one O-ring somewhere. We're missing this guy for something. But this one looks like it goes on right there. So, and then that's the grease there. So yeah, this boy was definitely time for a rebuild. I'm gonna put this over there. And well, dang, I'm gonna have to go look at the instructions. Pretty much figured it out without having to know, but maybe someone rebuilt this and they didn't put the O-ring in where it should be. So look. Okay, this is weird. It's different, but look, there's the O-ring just about that size right there inside there. So what's this guy doing here? Whew, and that goes up in there around it. All right, I'm gonna go read. I'm pretty sure this has to come out. And then we put that O-ring in because that goes around, maybe goes around this guy, I don't know. I said all kinds of great things about Haldex having documentation. And they don't. They don't on this part. It's kind of crazy. Anyway, this rubber flapper was in here. And they show it separate on the picture along with these two things when you go to buy it, and then the O-ring is already inside of there, so that's not right. Heck, I don't know. What am I missing here? Maybe right here? So I did search the site quite heavily. You know, this is a relay valve. It's repair instructions, but when I go to look at it, it doesn't really look like what I need. So the final, let's go tear this guy apart and see if we get lucky. Yeah, right. I hate using these because it leaves marks, but I'm pretty sure I don't. This is going to be like a 30 millimeter. Yep, there we go. So, oop. Ah, dang it. Did you see what happened? I dropped it. But the piece that was in there just fell out. There's the O-ring. There we go. A lot of good use. All right. And then this O-ring here. Matches up to this guy here. Pretty clean. All right, just putting a new O-ring on. Put the new valve in there. I'm just gonna set it in like this. look like I need to clean this guy up at all. Let's go ahead and put the new O-ring on it. Bingo. There's the old one. I'm gonna do some cleaning up on this. I'm not gonna use any solvent, I don't think. I don't wanna use any solvent on this at all. And why don't I want to use solvent? I just don't trust that it won't screw up the plastic. And pit in here. So I'm just gonna, it's gonna be boring for a minute. I'll cut this part out. I'm essentially just gonna wipe it down. Now the question is, what all gets lubed? Ah, here's where the leak was at. Right in that O-ring, right there. Let me see if you can see it. That's a nick on the O-ring right over here on this, by the way, with the fingers tapping. There you go. You can see that's what my problem was. Sweet. Okay. Now, I don't feel like there's any grease on there. Sure wish I would know. The Freightliner or decent mechanic ever comes through looking at me and laughing, leave me a comment. Let me know if I did this right or wrong. But I'm just going to grease in here and around the flying saucer, the diaphragm, and they're all back together. Silicone grease. So yeah, they don't really give you a lot. It's interesting how the other stuff was like clay red, or pinkish clay stuff. There we go. All right, reassemble. All right, put the flying saucer diaphragm back in there. There we go. Is it going right? Yeah. So that came down into there. The new O-ring is here, and guess what I forgot? Which way this stuff goes together? Was it like this? It was like that. But since I made a video, I gotta go check. I forgot. Thought I was recording. It's back together. This is the correct location of the top piece. I had a little problems with this fitting back, the O-ring snapping back together up here. But as I just carefully put those two bolts in there and just hand tightened them, I don't know what the inch pounds are on it. And then I reversed out, put this back together, and put the snap ring in. Very easy. I did was very careful to show to go in there without damaging it, because I did find out where I was leaking at. And let's see if we can get the light right. There we go. See how that O-ring is nicked? Right there was causing, excuse me, right there was causing all that air to escape out of here for I don't know how long. So yeah, something went through there and scored that up. And from what I understand, this is a pretty common failure point in all these exhaust valves. So when you're looking underneath, you'll see a lot of exhaust valves on the different components of the your system. And if something goes through and messes up, you know, gets caught in there, and these are leaking like crazy, that's because of something like this on the O-ring.
And then you can see, you know, it wasn't enough for me to fail on the pedal test, but I could tell my rear pressure wasn't up around 130. It was just a couple pounds lower than what the front was, even on the braking static test, but I was still in the parameters I was supposed to be in. Under the bus we go.
All right, so I need to get that in there further. See, it's about an eighth of an inch from meeting up, and it just won't bite. So essentially, I'm just going to tap on it a little bit on each side until I can get her in.
Interestingly enough, the rear is still, that's a little bit better. And yeah, I know how accurate the gauges are and stuff. Okay, I'm pressing on the brake. Should be holding at 100. Now I can hear an air leak underneath me, so I might have to do that valve next. Because I would say we are definitely failing on the front now, and not on the back. So it's just enough. You can't hear it because of the motor running. There went the release valve. So it looks like I need to take care of the valve between the, I might have to get my wife out here to step on the brake and we'll go figure it out just to make sure. But yeah, I mean, it's still within range. It's not within range. I really need to get that taken care of. So, goodness. It's not leaking anymore. Problem that I was finding was coming out of the Air Force connector, which I strapped off a long time ago. Let's get a better picture of that. So one of the owners before me probably had a Air Force style air brake in there. And whenever I press on it, you know, leaks. So it's been that way ever since I've owned it. I just didn't know because I had all kinds of other air leaks, so I have to figure out what to do here with this guy. And it's just a small hole. All right, so that's pretty doable. All right, so it's actually a brake master that they installed back there. And what's funny is this is what's supposed to be on the towed vehicle, is the male coupler, and that's what I have coming out the back. And the female is what should be there. So here's where that leak was coming from. This should be on the towed vehicle, and the female should be on here. I've seen it different ways on the internet, but it doesn't make sense for it to be on here. And each trailer has it both ways in their system. You know, this should be the female connector on the bus. And so it's been just every time the brake comes on, it's just free flowing air out of there. It's been that way ever since, you know, 2002 when they put this on there. Whoever did it wrong. So, you know, the old bus has been pumping, you know, more air than it ever should have. And, you know, it gets kind of dangerous sometimes because it gets low when you're sitting in a lot of traffic, I'd noticed. Anyway, I didn't have time to buy a new one before my trip, or that would replace it, the female from E-Trailer. It's $50. I went over to Lowe's, just went to the plumbing department, got a compression to an MIP, got the cap. So all we're gonna do is put the cap on, and then this will thread right onto here, just like it was. It's not DOT approved, but it's better than what it was. It'll probably stay like this for the remainder of the bus because I have a different braking system in my Toad than this this one. All right, wrapping it up, I just went and took it out for a test drive. My ABS didn't work, fix didn't work, so that's kind of disappointing. So brakes work great. It's nice not having any more leaks. I have to rate that one pretty easy to do, surprisingly easy to do. It's just daring enough to crawl under there and take it apart and put it back together. Even though there's no instructions there, hopefully I provided enough information that you can do it. Till next time.